of life. I've been around a long time. This is what I love to do. I live to do this. So I've had so many amazing things happen in my life, and certainly an unbelievable career. And that's partly why it's so beautiful to be here and do this tonight. But one of the things that really stands out that you guys probably know me for, first of all, was the fact that when I was 16, I was asked to be in a movie with Sidney Poitier. That was quite something, because I really didn't know what hit me. The first time, you know, when I was 15 and did Shell, I didn't know what hit me when I got to work with the Beatles and Stones. But then I get to be in a film, and then my very clever manager insisted I sing the title song, because they wanted to let me act in the film, but she insisted I do the song. Nobody made any effort to find the song, and they got me a load of rubbish. I was in tears, it was horrible. I sat down with a friend of mine who was Canadian. Yeah. And his name was Mark London. And I sat down with Mark, and he said, oh, they'll never use it, they'll never use it. I said, they will, because it's all rubbish they're giving. They don't even care, they don't know what they're doing. I sat there with him until he wrote the melody. We then sent the script to a very famous lyricist called Don Black, who had written Born Free and a couple of Bond songs. I was very well known. And he managed a guy called Matt Monroe, who my father used to love. And he came up with the incredible lyric, the song. My producer didn't care about it. He didn't even want it to go out. He put it, as I mentioned before, on the B side, and put The Boat That I Row in the A side. And I was livid. But I could do nothing about it. I feel like I seem to cry all the time. Argue with people and cry. Anyway, the jockeys in the US turned over. And then the rest of the world got it. And, you know, I suppose the rest is history, because it was a huge success. But the cute thing is that, I mean, I saw myself on the screen, I thought, oh my God, you are so ugly. Oh my God, this is a terrible film, and I hope nobody ever sees it. But that's what you think about when you're a teenager, how you are, you know. And I couldn't see further than that. And I got a telegram from Columbia Pictures saying, To Serve With Love has broken all box office records in the history of Colombian movies, and the world is asking, where is Lulu? So that was it. I mean, I'm now connected to that beautiful man, Sidney Poitier, to the message in that film that is so special, still very, very relevant today. And I will always be grateful for it. And now I'd like to sing for you tonight, To Sow With Love. He knows how to get around me. Boss. 2, 3.